Hi, this is Alexandra from Kitfox Games. In this tutorial, written by DPH Kraken, we'll explore how Dwarf Fortress generates creatures and how you can use this in your own mods. If you're new to Lua modding for Dwarf Fortress, check out the first video in this tutorial series. The scripts for vanilla procedural creatures use a number of specialized functions. While each function only specifies a few tokens, the principle of creating a raw file to be registered is still at play. It's entirely possible to generate a custom creature without using the vanilla library, but this tutorial will be primarily focused on the vanilla systems. This is the script of a forgotten beast. Of the vanilla creatures, this is the simplest example. Let's walk through it. First, it sets a few options for functions later and adds a block of tokens. Then it calls add regular tokens, which adds a couple of tokens to the table based on its options. It checks the layer argument, adds the right biome and sphere. It rolls on the evil spheres table, then calls populate sphere info to write the sphere tokens. Then it picks a random creature profile, which is the template for what kind of animal it is. The options can affect this. For example, options.dowater from being in a water layer makes it have to choose something aquatic like a toad. Random creature profiles parameters are used to set the ASCII creature tile sizes and finally run through build proc gen creature, a massive function that finalizes the procedural creature. We'll get into the specifics of that later. These functions are shared by all the vanilla procedural creatures, and we can use them to generate our own creature. This will be our example creature function, which we will use to streamline testing. This is the list of random creature types. This has all the profiles for the vanilla creatures, and you can see that each entry has a couple of properties. It's got its nice name, the tile, the minimum size it expects, its weight or rarity, some flags, and some interesting properties. Body base points to a function which defines even more data. These are very much tied to token values in the raw it outputs. The body parts and walking parameters should be familiar if you've modded the raws, while the PCG layering value determines what set of graphics it should use. Notably, you can use PCG layering in your own raws and use the procedural creature graphics even if you don't use the build proc gen creature function that normally assigns these tokens. Also note the creature class, which determines the tissues that the creature has. There's a couple of organic ones, whereas uniform is special. It makes the creature out of a single material. This could be stone, fire, or any other kind of random creature material. It's also possible to define our own entries. Here's an example of how you can set the RCP table locally. We can define it in the creature itself. Some night creatures do this, always having a humanoid profile. We can use this principle to create a new profile for Eurypterids, an extinct creature also known as the sea scorpion. Let's put our RCPs to use. We'll be making a version of werebeasts that are insectoid instead of quadrupeds. First, we'll want to have a global version of the Eurypterid profile. We'll define it in random creature types, give it a new body-based function with flippers, and list it as water-based. Now we can make a list of all the bugs and creepy crawlies we want our new monsters to generate as. We'll copy the werebeast function and change the way it selects its RCP to pick from our own table. We'll make it also suck blood like a vampire if the RCP matches certain parameters. A few tweaks and we should be able to place our werebug in the arena. We've set it to override the default for easy testing, but it can just as easily become an alternative to the regular werebeast species. While we start from the RCP describing a natural or basic form, most procedural creatures have tweaks. A third eye, a pair of wings, even gaining a coat of fur. The options table can determine what tweaks are available or forced for a creature. For example, options.humanoid-only, common to night creatures, automatically makes them humanoid. Setting options.strong-attack-tweak gives a creature a special attack like poison or fire breath. You can set options.no-tweak to avoid randomized tweaks. A creature's class is normally specified by its RCP, but can have their surface changed through tweaks. Evil creatures can become skinless, for example. By default, creatures have a 1 in 20 chance to become uniform. Certain options can configure which materials are available, but options.sphere-RCM allows for precise control of what materials your creature will be made of. This is normally set by options.do-sphere-RCM when populating sphere info, but you can set it to any value in random creature materials. material. Let's put materials to work in a variant of Forgotten Beasts, elementals. We'll have a table to hold the different random elements, their name, options to set, and their material. For example, air elementals will have the intangible flyer option, allowing them to fly as if they were made of gas. We'll handle water elementals a little differently. They'll be the only option in water layers. Let's browse a world with this script and look at all the different elementals that roam the caverns. You'll notice that each one has a fitting name based on its fears. The usual method of changing generator behavior is through adding and overwriting functions and values in tables. However, at different stages of the build function, different tables have functions run from them. This allows us to patch in data from every creature generated this way, while keeping compatibility in mind. Let's make every elephant-sized random creature become an intelligent power that can impersonate deities. We've added this function to BTC1Tweaks, which is run right before the first tweak is determined. When we generate a world with this, it'll literally be ruled by Forgotten Beasts and Primeval Titan Masters. Now that you've learned how procedural creatures work, there's lots of ways you could make your own. You could draw from myths and legends, or limit profiles to a theme like prehistoric creatures. There's lots of data to play around with when generating a name, too. The scripts from this video are on the Dwarf Fortress Wiki, where you can find more information on all the different creature options. You can share your creations and get feedback in the DF modding section of the KitFox Discord. The links for everything will be in the description.